cause I'm on one.
You know, we have ones that's a Rastafari, live in the city,
yeah.
Kingston City,
Manhattan,
yeah. Like I, you yeah. know. We live amongst our universal brothers and sisters, and Rastafari is for each and everyone, so it's not a...
Swinging for the fences for the home run. Even further beyond into the universe, but I've got to make it to first.
Heard that message from the 12 seers of Mount Zion. They said the black nation will be blessed by God in these days. Circle the mountain and go home. Shabbat.
Mount Zion calling me.
And now let's catch ones up on Latin America news, and even so tying the Caribbean in with this as well. But even so, we have to really, you know, again, be straightforward and honest about this. A lot of what goes on in the Caribbean and Central and South America, you know, usually has its stemming from a lot of the things that go on in North America and usually the West. You know, again, with a lot of the, you know, just recent history, as far as the things that have gone on between Western Europe, from North, Central, and South America to the Caribbean, you know, a lot of the things that have gone on between those places usually are intertwined when we deal with history, archaeology, and even so, you know, a lot of ancient history as well, you know, for those doing more so of these anthropological and archaeological studies. But even so, with the recent history, that continues to give us, you know, our notions in which we can not only predict but assess and analyze where certain things are headed. And even so, with this report here from Al Jazeera speaking on Trinidad and Venezuela, as we're about to get into this reading, you know, we have reported somewhat on a lot of the things that have gone on in Venezuela, especially politically, and hopefully ones have taken to heart a lot of those reports, because that is a very interesting topic, a hot topic, we should say, there in South America, and has sprung and has had its effects all over the world, reaching all the way over into the Persian Gulf. So hopefully, you know, ones are taking that in as well and doing some examinations, especially if they work in the oil and gas sector, you know, whether certain ones work, may just work as an attendant at a gas station or so, or maybe have looked to get into certain oil industry, whether that be importing or exporting certain things. In that fashion, also working where oil and gas and other derivatives of, you know, that particular sector tend to stem into, you know, you tend to pay attention to certain things that you usually spend most of your time with. So that, you know, brings us into a certain level of thinking as far as how these things are governed from particular nations and also regions in that sense. And how ones utilize a lot of these natural resources to the best of their benefit, you know, and some may lag in that sense. And also, you know, how certain political powers tend to leverage a lot of these natural resources, you know, whether that be for, you know, altruistic purposes or nefarious ones. But continuing on here with Al Jazeera entitled, Trinidad cancels gas deal over U.S. sanctions on Venezuela. Subtitled, the Caribbean nation cancels an agreement with Venezuela to jointly develop natural gas field due to U.S. sanctions on PDVSA. So continue on here. Trinidad and Tobago has canceled an agreement with Venezuela for the joint development of a natural gas field straddling the maritime border because of United States sanctions on Venezuela's state energy giant, Petroleos de Venezuela S.A., or the PDVSA we mentioned in the title. This is the great energy state giant of Venezuela. Many ones didn't know before a lot of the political turmoil that has befallen Venezuela at this point was because Venezuela was such a huge player in the oil and gas sector. And even so, we mentioned from our last report with the South China Morning Post dealing with Indonesia and a lot of the countries or the political figures there in Indonesia looking to relieve themselves of having to use so many fossil fuels in that sense, or getting out of the oil and gas sector to continue to develop, because they see a lot of the political or the geopolitical shifting going on. So here, continuing on, the Caribbean island nation is a major exporter of liquefied natural gas, or LNG, but its own offshore natural gas output has been declining in recent years. That has raised the possibility of using gas from neighboring Venezuela, which has large untapped offshore gas reserves, to feed LNG plants in Trinidad. Trinidad and Tobago's Prime Minister Keith Rowley said on Monday during an energy conference in Port of Spain that two countries will now independently develop the 283 billion cubic meter, or the 10.04 trillion cubic foot, Loran Manati shallow water natural gas field. Progress in the development of the unitized Loran Manati field has been impeded by the sanctions imposed by the U.S. government, which inhibits U.S. companies from doing business with Venezuelan oil company PDVSA, Rowley said. Under the agreement signed in 2013 between the two countries, 73.75% of the joint field belongs to Venezuela and the rest to Trinidad and Tobago. U.S. oil major Chevron Corp. holds a 60% interest in the Loran field, which the remainder is held by PDVSA, while Shell Trinidad and Tobago Limited holds a 100% interest in the Manatee field. PDVSA, the Venezuelan oil ministry, Chevron and Shell did not immediately respond to Reuters news agency request for comment. The U.S. Department of the Treasury slapped sanctions on PDVSA last year in a bid to oust Venezuela's socialist president, Nicolas Maduro. He has overseen an economic collapse and is accused by the U.S. of others and others of corruption and human rights violations. PDVSA's output has declined, but exports have increased in recent months, and Maduro remains in power. Rowley said gas production from the Manatee field could start by 2024 or 2025 at rates ranging from 7 to 11 million cubic meters, or 270 to 400 million standard cubic feet per day. He said the decision to independently develop the fields also has implications for the development of other cross-border fields that straddle the two countries, the Mancan-Kukwani and the Copac-Dorado. These are estimated to hold 24 billion cubic meters or 850 billion cubic feet of gas within the Trinidad and Tobago maritime area. This concludes the reading for that report. And again, hopefully ones can now see how a lot of these natural resources play such, you know, a position on a chessboard in a sense as to how certain governments tend to deal with each other. And again, as a report here mentions from Al Jazeera, that Nicolas Maduro is still in power, but of course he was challenged by what we could clearly see was a U.S.-backed candidate for the presidential office there in Venezuela, and that was with Juan Guaido. Guaido's campaign has since ceased. A lot of the economic pressures that were levied upon Venezuela have indeed taken their toll, but with Venezuela having such a history of independence in one sense, and also defiance, you know, to certain particular nations, you know, it has in a sense sustained itself, you know, from complete or total collapse, but yet and still economically has suffered very damaging, we should say, effects financially in that sense to the greater extent of the country, where there was to the tunes of, we should say, hundreds of millions or so people who have, you know, escaped and taken refuge in other neighboring countries, as well as far-fetched countries, even so to the U.S. and other places in Western Europe, particularly that of the Spanish-speaking sectors of society. And, you know, again, that all has taken its toll on, you know, again, not Latin America to that greater extent, position to certain geopolitical powers as far as the international scale is concerned. And again, that has played its part. And, you know, again, following the streams, you know, of content as well as certain events which have been recorded and also shared, you know, as much as possible in this sense, you know, with all of the information, we tend, again, to find a lot of the narratives, you know, to have a streamline to where ones can actually follow a lot of these stories if they are diligent in keeping up with, you know, all of the happenings that go on in and around.